Taste and see the Lord is good. How do you know honey is good? Because you've had it before. How do you explain the taste of honey? Unless you've had it. But if somebody hasn't had it, it's almost impossible to explain how sweet and how good it is. This week we're talking about blessed are those who hunger and thirst after righteousness, for they shall be filled. That has been our discussion all week long. And today, for today's discussion, I want you to have on hand some honey. Of course, your Bible. And a journal. Because today we're going to talk about journaling and meditation. The Word of God is something that God has given us to satisfy our souls, to fill us. But I want to teach you how to find satisfaction in it. Not just through Bible study, but through what I would call a devotional life in God's Word. I call it the five fingers of journalism. This is how I started off really learning to love the Bible. I call it five fingers because what you need to do is have a journal. And you're going to write five things down in this journal. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And I want to explain to you what those five things are. So first we're going to start with the pinky as number one. I'm going to call this first part, question is, how am I today? Write that question down and then answer it. As if you're speaking to God face to face, but I want you to write it in the journal because when you write in a journal, it solidifies your thoughts. And it makes them very clear and you don't drift off saying the same things that you would just by praying. Normally when people pray, they're just, dear God, when you write down this, how am I doing today, taking a journal and a pen forces you to think through really how you're doing. Sometimes when I journal, this is all I talk about. Because my my purpose in journaling is relationship, not study. Relationship, and to trust the heart of God. And when I write, how am I doing today, I am writing as if God is my friend. Write down how you're doing today. Sometimes I write miserable. Sometimes I write, I can't believe how beautiful it is outside. Thank you, God. Sometimes I'm really worried. Let him know. I have had two or three whole pages of answering number one. Sometimes I've had one line. I'm doing great. Then we go to the second finger. I call this number two. And this is writing the verse word by word. So I'm just going to write the verse. So you just write down the verse. What I like to do before I do a devotion is I like to pray in the table of contents in my Bible. And the table of contents is at the very beginning of the Bible. And it will list every book for you. And I'll pray through it. So here's my books right here. This is the Old Testament, New Testament. I'll say, God, what book do you want me to do a devotion in? Sometimes I'll be stuck in a book for a month, 2 months, 3 months. I was in a book of Jeremiah one time, 6 months. Sometimes I go pretty quick through a book. Like you can go through Jude pretty quickly. But you pray through this, and then I like to mark what books I've done before. But often through prayer, God will say, Chris, you need to do this book. So let's just say I've been going through the book of John. And my verse for today is John 11:35. John 11:35 is simply this. Jesus wept. Jesus wept. That's John 11:35. This is going to be the verse I work on. So then what do? Is I go to point number three. After I have the verse written down, and it's great to write the verse down because the words will start sinking in. Number three, I take a detailed devotion of each word. So this word is Jesus is the first word. And I write down what comes to mind when I think of Jesus. I'll write stuff like, Son of God, my King, perfection. So I'll think through that. Sometimes that takes a while. The second word I do is then I go through the next word, and this word wept. What does weep mean? It means to grieve, be broken, heavy emotion. So I've got my words defined. Then here is where it gets interesting. This is where devotion comes into play. I let these words sink in, and then I start thinking about them. So this is where number four comes in. And as I think about them, the Son of God wept. Wow! God has emotions. And then if you think about what he wept about his friend, those he loved. So God cares about me. And you can think through 100 different devotions. So you can think of weeping. God is broken for the brokenhearted. There are some things that disturb him. Jesus sees everything. Like, there's all kind of applications just on one little verse. This can go a long time. Sometimes when I'm heavier theology, like the book of Romans or Hebrews, I'll have 2 pages just on 4, which is observations. Those are called observations. And then what I'll do is, the fifth one is applied prayer. So I will apply this in prayer. And I'll use the idea that Jesus wept. Jesus, you see me. And there's things that are really bothering me. I hope your emotions, I hope you see me today. See me in my relationships. See my hurt. Jesus, please comfort me. And when you take all of these, what happens is the words start sinking in a relational way. This isn't necessarily for theology and study in the sense of I'm ready to give a sermon. This is to be fed, to say, I delight in God and his word. Because he gave us his word so we can delight in it. So after I go through these 5, then what I do is I meditate on the verse. So Jesus wept. I learn it. Often I'll go walking in the woods and pray through it, or I'll sing a song about it. But the idea of meditation is, now that I know what the idea is or what it's saying, I keep saying it through the day. So I learn the verse all through the day. When you meditate and then you memorize it, that's the third stage. As I'd say, you journal, meditate, and then the third stage is memorize. Then God's word stores in your heart. It's stored in there. I did the book of John one time where I wanted to learn the whole thing. And I just started, and I would go to my job site repeating what I learned. In the beginning was the word, and word was with God. The word was God. The same was in the beginning with God. All things were made by him. Without him was not anything made that was made. In him was life. And that life, it's the light of men. The light shines in the darkness. And what happens, it sinks in you. And you start tasting it. It becomes good. But you have to process. So I'll have whole journals. I'll have whole journals where I'm going through my life. I would pray for my kids. I would usually, what's interesting is each verse I had for the day applied to the situation at hand. And then as you'll start seeing that devotions are how you get to know the heart of God. It's how you get to know him. It's like this. I can't explain it to you. Some of my devotions were so good that in the middle of it, it's kind of like taking this honey and putting it in a big spoon. And I can tell you how good this is, but watch when I eat it. Watch my face. Like right now, it's kind of stoic. Man, that's good. That's like the book of John. That's like book of Jeremiah for me. Or lately we've been going through Matthew. Blessed are those who hunger and thirst after righteousness. They shall be filled. Wow. God will fulfill that. So, get a journal, write a hand on the front, and do the